Hello, everybody, and welcome to Listen Up. I'm Brennan Buote. You're in for a show full of excitement, so stay tuned until the end. On Monday, November 21st, the annual Powder Puff game took place at Battis Field. I got a chance to enjoy the game and meet up with some of the people behind this fun event. Let's check it out.
Powder Puff game has been going for quite some time. I know that probably about maybe 15 years ago we added the bonfire to the mix, and it has been really a nice tradition to kick off Spirit Week and the week of Thanksgiving.
And my favorite part of this event was definitely the cheerleading. I thought the cheerleading was a blast. You know, I was cheerleading with all my buddies, and honestly, our routine came out pretty top-notch. I was really, toggling back and forth with taking my shirt off or not. And I figured, why wouldn't you take a shirt off in a situation like that? You know, why would you not take a shirt off? And then I took my shirt off. And that was fun, you know, it was cool.
No, I thought it would be fun watching the junior girls versus senior girls face off. Maybe the fire after could be pretty fun.
The two classes, the juniors and seniors, plan it. And they put together the teams, they put together the coaches. It is truly student run. And our job as a school is to support it and to do all the logistical things for them.
On November 23rd, MHS had its annual Thanksgiving pep rally. There was a performance by the cheerleaders, twirlers, and the band. Let's check it out. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, when you dance, 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 feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, 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 go. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, 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 dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. The Sachem football team had a great season, finishing off with a win against Carver in their annual Thanksgiving game to make their record 7-4. Congrats to all of the seniors on their final season. Here's the season highlight put together by Delaney Brennan.
How hit the fan like, all day like, all night like, watch black like, offense like, defense like, squad like, let's go like, and it's down like, and it's down like.
Thank you. Coming up, we have a highlight of the fall show. But first, here are some of the commercials made by TV1's Chris Cogan and Declan Hastings.
The Mind Thief is designed to be a simple and reliable spying tool. With just a simple toss of a chip for just $75 a month or $800 a year, you'll be able to see into people's minds.
Ugh, I'm so hungry.
Here's what's going on in Matt's head. Call 1-800-MINDTHIEF. That is 1-800-MINDTHIEF.
Yeah, no. Magic map.
Magic map. A map that takes you anywhere.
Matt, do you have your homework?
Magic map. Coming 2017.
On November 18th, MHS put on the play Game of Tiaras, and Serina Grant got a chance to make a highlight of the play. Here it is.
On November 18th and 19th, Middleborough High School students host their first play of the school year, Game of Tiaras. They pack the auditorium seats with family and friends. With all the plot twists in the play, they always kept the audience laughing and enjoying it. Amazing singing performances by Ariana and Shannon. Great job, Middleborough High School students. We all can't wait to see what you have planned next.
The MHS Music Department is in the beginning stages of rehearsal for this year's musical, Camp Rock. Megan Doherty was there to check out a few rehearsals. Let's take a look.
It's a brand new day here at MHS as I took a look at this year's annual musical put on by the Music Department.
So we're doing Camp Rock the musical this year, and I've never really been in the musical this year, so it's actually really fun for me to be able to get involved with this. I'm involved with a couple other things. But the musical this year, it's a lot of fun. It's a combination between the first Camp Rock and the second Camp Rock. It follows the storyline more of the second Camp Rock, but it's got some of the songs that everybody knows and loves from the first one.
My least favorite part about it is probably the time it takes to put a show together, because it takes all the rehearsal, but meanwhile, all that time is like going to result in something great, so I can get over the time it takes for the result.
My favorite character is Jason.
I like Jason, and he's one of the brothers, the Jonas Brothers, because he's like the funny one, and he's always like positive, and he's not always the smartest, but like I think it makes it better.
So I play Jason Gray, which is Kevin Jonas in the movies. I'm the oldest of the three members of the band, Connect Three. He's a very strange man, strange guy, a little psychotic, you know, not psychotic, but a little crazy, you know. He's fun though.
Really? I think anyone can join. You'd probably fit in. I mean, you definitely fit in. even if like you're a jock or you like to do sports or you are more into school and want to join like the more academic related clubs, I think anyone can really enjoy theater and music. And they'd definitely fit in, they'd make a lot of friends, and it'd be a lot of fun for them.
This tight-knit cast will be performing on January 27th, 28th, and 29th for $8 at MHS. There's no denying that they are putting their blood, sweat, and tears into every rehearsal, and they hope that it will show on stage. This has been Megan Doherty with Listen Up.
On October 13th, the Middleborough High School Band and Orchestra, accompanied by the Concert Choir and Sachem Singers, put on a wonderful show. Megan Doherty put together an amazing video. Let's check it out. Coming up, a news story on our new one-to-one computer program. But first, here are more commercials produced by TV1's Hannah Stearns and Kaylee Tobin.
Have you ever wore clothing not appropriate to the weather? Well, Weather to Wear will not let that happen again. But with Weather to Wear, it gives you two options, so this won't happen to you. Sometimes it's hard picking out what you want to wear because you don't know what the weather's gonna be like. No more messy rooms with Weather to Wear. Weather to Wear will tell you what to wear straight from your closet, picking out cute and stylish outfits. Download Weather to Wear for $4.99 on both iTunes and Androids. Download in the next 15 minutes to get Weather to Wear half off. Visit our website for more awesome features at www.weathertowear.com/weather.
Said you can't cross the finish line first? Try energy spray.
Just spray it all over your body and you get instant energy. Don't waste time or money drinking unhealthy energy drinks. Get energy spray. Get energy spray. You'll cross the finish line first.
During the week of November 14th, the District of Middleborough, for the first time, launched the one-to-one program in the middle and high school. Here's Hannah Melendy with more on the program.
The District of Middleborough began to start a path to a better learning environment by launching the one-to-one program. The program, in the long run, is hoped to bring big success to the town.
The one-to-one program is a really exciting initiative at the high school where that all of our students received a device, a laptop computer, to carry with them from class to class, but also at the high school, they're actually bringing the devices home.
Oh, I'm really excited for it. I think it's great. I think it helps to level the playing field with all kids, giving them the same access to technology. And I think the kids are really excited about it. The world has changed. Kids are on their devices, and it's just nice to have really good devices to put in their hands.
The One program is a great accelerator for MHS to really get into the 21st century and really help kids with their education.
So far, it has been really a great, it's been great. We've had a few issues here and there, but the technology department has been wonderful of troubleshooting, working with students, coming up with protocols of what happens if a student can't get on a device. But from overall, I think our students have been quite happy with them. I know our teachers have been quite happy. I think our teachers have been really waiting for this to get started, so which has been quite excited.
I do think this program will improve the learning because it opens up a lot of possibilities for kids who don't have access to the internet all the time.
I'm really excited for the stats program specifically. To be considered a real collegiate stats course, kids should have exposure to technical advantages like StatCrunch or a program. And this is going to give those kids that. They've already worked on projects and shown that they can do college-level work with computers right in the classroom, so it's great.
Thank you to all the members of the community who helped organize the program. It is sure to be a success. This has been Hannah Melendy for Listen Up.
On November 10th, MHS was trained on the Middleborough Public Schools response options. Firefighters and police officers from Middleborough and Bourne came to make sure the students knew what to do if there was an armed intruder entering the building. Here's Isabel Perry with the story.
Over the past few years, Middleborough's District Emergency Response Team has been training students and staff on what they need to be aware of in case of any school emergency. On November 10th, the high school got trained. I got the chance to talk to Mr. Dizell, a member of the response team.
And so all the students took part in about a 40-minute presentation in the auditorium, and we did that by class. And then in the afternoon, all the support staff that I mentioned earlier went classroom to classroom, really working with students on how to properly barricade a classroom if ever the need would arise.
On that day, we had a lockdown training where we basically, the firefighter in our room came in the room. He talked to us basically about what you would do, how we can either, if it's necessary, if we can escape, get out of the building to do that. If not, barricade as much as you can on the door, take chairs, tables. We took file cabinets, push them against the door, and then some people decided they were going to pick up chairs, throw them on top, and he said that was fine, so we did that. And then turned off the lights, hunkered in the corner, and then waited.
I think students need to understand that the possibility for this is very real and it could happen anywhere, and they need to be prepared and have themselves mentally ready so that they know what to do. Unfortunately, it's no different than being ready for a fire alarm, the same way we do fire drills every year and practice evacuating. The drill is meant to teach students what to do so that they're ready to do it if they need to do it. Hopefully they never do.
Barely happens, but it has been picking up lately, so I would say not really. But at the same time, they should think about, look around when they get into a room, think of where the exits are if something does happen.
No, I don't think students should be worried. I think they should be prepared. Those are two different things.
Ohio State University just suffered an active shooter event on their grounds, and it just really puts everything into perspective. And how important it is to be prepared, just to be aware and to be aware of the options that you have at your disposal.
As a firefighter and an EMT, we're going to be responding with the police. The police are going to try to barricade or isolate a shooter in a particular area of the school. So when you see us, our directions can be just as important as the teacher's directions. And if there's no adults around and you end up there on your own, you're waiting for police officer or a firefighter to come and get you.
We have more than 60 cameras inside Middleborough High School, and we have more than 15 around the perimeter outside the school.
I would say the cameras are definitely an advantage because, let's say someone does walk in, whoever's in the camera room can view where they are exactly and basically tell us over the intercom or possibly the radio, some teachers have radios, where they are and if they're coming that way, so we can get notified of what might happen, what we can get around of if he's able to tackle them, or however it's going
to
work.
To know that students are empowered to listen to their teachers, to make decisions on their own in their own self-best interest, to make sure that they are being as absolutely proactive in their safety as they can be, I think is the real takeaway from the high school training. The message that we want all the kids to take home is, whether it's in time of emergency or whether it's not, the most important thing that you can do in a school is listen to your teacher, follow the direction, and based on the information that they have at their disposal, you'll all collectively make the best decisions in your own self-interest.
So as long as you do what you're supposed to do, we're going to do what we're supposed to do, and everybody's going to be safe, and hopefully we can get everybody to safety with no problems.
Coming up soon is a look at the Nichols Middle School musical. But first, here are two commercials put together by TV1's Matt DeRosiers and Sarah Bourget.
Wow, this is great. What is it?
Chris Cogan here. Visionation is so much more better than just a video game because it brings everything to life.
How does it work?
Once you have the glasses on, press the power button that is located on the right side to turn on Visionation.
Tell everyone. Wow, this is so cool.
But wait, there's more. If you press the blue button on the left side.
Thanks, Vision Nation.
No, thank you for being so creative.
On December 10th, students from John T. Nichols Middle School performed the play Bye Bye Birdie. They have practiced it for months and were very eager to be able to show the community what they have been working so hard on. Joseph Escolas made a highlight of the event. Let's check it out.
If what you feel is true, you really feel it, you make them feel it too. Write this down now, you gotta be sincere. Honestly sincere, man, you gotta be sincere.
if you're really sincere, if you feel it in here, then it's gotta be right on, baby. Oh, honey, help me, I suffer. In everything I do, why my sincerity shows through. Yeah, I look you in the eye, I don't even have to try. It's automatic, I'm sincere. When I sing about a tree, listen, why I really feel that tree. Yeah, when I sing about a girl, I really feel that girl. I mean, I really feel. If you feel it in here, then it's gotta be right on, baby. Oh, honey, hug me. I suffer.
Thanks for watching our production of Listen Up. The videos do not stop here. We are always pushing new videos and photos to all digital platforms. We are on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. We also have a great new website with all the videos that we produce. Thanks for watching, and until next time, I'm Brandon Buote.